सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
Pranayama is an art by slowing down the breath, calming the mind. Pranayama is a journey in the path of awareness towards the freedom. Aim of pranayama practice, inner effulgence is uncovered. Mind becomes capable of dharana, which is a premeditative state, calms down the mind, reaching to the state of complete silence. Awakening of the Kundalini, even the practitioner reach to the state of Samadhi, even one can achieve by practice of Pranayama total freedom. Pranayama, the word is split into two words. Prana is the vital force or the vitality. Ayama is to control or one can practice and expand the consciousness. Schools of Pranayama. There are two schools. One is Patanjali Yoga School, another is Hatha Yoga School. Definitions of Pranayama according to Patanjali Yoga Schools. Let us go for the definition.
Tasmin sati shvasa prashvasa yor gati vichheda pranayamaha.
It means controlling the motion of the exhalation and the inhalation follows after this. Pranayama, the two words has been splitted like pranasyayama iti pranayama. Pranayama is a science of cleansing, balancing, gaining control over prana, gaining control over any of the five prana. Pranayama, the pancha pranas are the five vital forces. Number one is prana, second is udana, third is samana, fourth is apana, and the fifth one is vyana. Pancha pranas and their locations and the functions. Prana location is the heart, hridaya, governs the functions like breathing, seeing, smelling, thinking, heartbeat. Udana, the place is throat, governs the functions like belching, hiccups, vomiting, and takes away the prana at the time of death. Samana, the place is at navel, balance the prana and apana, and it carry the functions of digestions, even the liver, pancreas, stomach, and the secretions of the various enzymes taken care of by this prana. Apana, location is at anus. The functions are excretory functions, peristalsis movement, urinations, menstrual cycles, and discharge of semen. Vyana, which is located all over the body and governs the various type of functions like sensations, touch, blood circulations, control all the movements and coordinates with other pranas. This classification is based on the area in which prana functions. Design of pranayama, the methods we have to go for: prayer to vibrate the body and prepare ourselves, preparations observing the breath and awareness of the vital sheath or the pranamaya kosha, practice of various techniques and achieving the relaxations and witnessing the state of silence, In this, we are completely tuning the techniques to the nostrils, where there are right nostril and the left nostril. Right nostril is known as Surya Nadi or Pingala Nadi in subtler level, and left nostril is related to the Chandra Nadi, and in subtler level it is Ida. Pranayama terminologies in the text: inhalation is Puraka, exhalation is Rechaka. If we hold the breath, it is known as Kumbhaka. When we breathe in, it is known as Anuloma. When we breathe out, it is known as Viloma. When we inhale and hold the breath, it is Antar Kumbhaka, internal holding. When we exhale and hold the breath, it is called Bahya Kumbhaka, external holding. And when we practice regularly pranayama, we achieve Sahaja Kumbhaka or Kevala Kumbhaka. Let us begin with the prayer.
Pranasyedam vashe sarvam tridive yat pratishthitam mateva putran rakshasva shrecha prajnyasya videhinaiti shrecha prajnyasya videhinaiti.
Nadanusandhana is known as sound resonance practice. In this practice, we go for various kind of chanting like Akara, Ukara, Makara, even combinedly the Omkara chanting. There are a lot of benefit of this practice which help us to open up the prana blockage, increase the vibrations in the body which help us to increase the blood circulations, develop our immunity, finally help us to merge in the deeper state of silence. No limitations of this practice. Nadanusandhana. First, we are going for the chanting of Akara with the Chin Mudra. Sit in any meditative posture with the Chin Mudra. Be aware of the lower part of the body, waist to the toes. Take a deep inhalation. Chant Akara. After completing the few rounds of practice, stop it, observe the changes within you. Nadanusandhana Ukara chanting with the Chinmaya Mudra for the middle part of the body. Sit in meditative posture with Chinmaya Mudra. Inhale deeply. Thank you. ಪ್ರಾಣಾಯಾಮದನುಸಂಧಾನ ದ ಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಕಾರ ವಿತ್ ಆದಿ ಮುದ್ರಾ. Sit in any comfortable meditative posture with the Adi Mudra, thumb inside, make a loose fist, inhale completely. After completing few rounds of chanting, stop the chanting, enjoy the vibrations at your heart region. Nadanusandhana, the combined chanting of akara, ukara, makara in a single breath in the ratio of 1:1:2. Sit in any meditative posture like Padmasana with Adi Mudra and try to place both the Adi Mudra below the navel, which becomes Brahma Mudra. Now take a deep inhalation and chant A Om Akara combinedly. Repeat few rounds of practice and enjoy the practice. After completing the practice, stop the practice, release the mudra, observe the changes in your body, adopt Namaskara Mudra aware of the relaxation, calmness, serenity and tranquil state of mind. Observe the complete relaxations. Each and every part of your body is totally relaxed. and the mind is dwelling to the deeper state of silence. Let us conclude the session with closing prayer.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukha bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti. Thank you.